Hi, I'm Chris Edwards and welcome to this week's Tennis Warehouse vlog. This week we're going to go over hybrid strings. Why would you want a hybrid and what are some of your options out there? And as you can see in this old trusty Prestige right here, 600, this is an old classic Prestige Pro from back in the day. I have a hybrid string set up in here and I've got an orange main string right there with a black cross string here. And I actually have two different polys in this string and I've varied both the type of poly I'm using and the gauge. Now, some of the things you can do with your hybrid and why you'd wanna do a hybrid is to get the benefits of two different types of strings. So say you're playing with a string setup, but you wanna add just a little bit of control or a little bit more durability to your favorite string, there are a couple of things you can do. First thing you can do is stay with the same string, and if available, go to a thicker gauge in the main strings, and that's gonna firm up the string bed even at the same tension, and it's gonna offer you more durability just because there's more string mass in the mains, and you can stick with your regular gauge in the crosses. So say I was using a 17 gauge multifilament, if I went to a 16 gauge version of that in my main strings, or a 15L if it's available, and then kept the 17 in the crosses, I would add a bit of control and a bit of durability to the string I was already using. So if I wanted to conversely add power and comfort, I could go the other way and add a thinner gauge to the mains. So the main strings are going to be the main influences on your hybrid setup. So whatever you put in the mains, that's what you're going to feel the benefit the most of out there on the court. So with a couple of things you can do, and very popular on the Pro Tour, is I have a set of Natural Gut right here, and then also have one of my favorite polys, which is Vocal Cyclone. Now, if I take the Gut string and I put that in the mains, I'm gonna get great power, comfort, and some good feel from the Natural Gut. But the poly in the cross is gonna bring in some control. It's gonna help the gut slide around and snap back, and so it's gonna add some spin to my string bed too. And it's gonna give me a more modern, control, spin-friendly response, which is complementing the power and the comfort of the Natural Gut. So it's a great way. Now, if I switch them and I put the Cyclone in the mains and the Natural Gut in the crosses, now I'm getting most of the control and durability of the poly, which is a very stiff, firm feeling string, and it's complemented by the softer, more powerful material of the Natural Gut. And so I'm gonna get a slightly more powerful and softer playing string bed than I would if I went full poly. But it's obviously going to be much more firmer and controlled than if I went all Natural Gut, or if I went Natural Gut in the mains and poly in the crosses. So you can play around with it in a couple of different ways there as well. Now, if you're on a budget, but you're looking for great playability, I think an awesome way to go is to get a multifilament like this. It's a really nice, soft, very pliable string, very arm friendly, great playability from this. Going to really pocket the ball well, give you a ton of feel out there. But multifilaments do tend to be quite expensive. You're going to be looking anywhere between roughly about $10 to $20 for a good multi. You can complement it with a synthetic gut. I've got a basic synthetic gut here. It's a little firmer feeling. Now, if I put this in the crosses, I'm still gonna get most of the benefit of my multifilament, but I'm gonna save by using a half set of a much cheaper string. I can get a good set of synthetic gut for under $5, and I can put that in the crosses. It really brings down the cost of that string bed, and you basically just take a half set of each. Half go in the mains of the multi, and then half in the crosses with the singer. And I'm still getting great playability, but at a reduced cost. So you can play around with that too and get a nice budget offer. And you can also try two different types of polys, which is what I was experimenting with right there in my racquet. And so I'm just looking to blend the characteristics of two polys I really like to see if it can make an even better version. And you can play around with it that way and have some fun. I also really like to play around when I'm using two different polys in a hybrid with the gauges, trying a really thin 19 gauge, say poly main string with a firmer, stiffer 16 gauge in the crosses, see how that plays. And then you can flip it as well if you want more durability, more control, and see what that offers you. So those are some of the reasons why you can use a hybrid. Another great thing you can do is go Natural Gut mains and a multi in the cross, and I found that to really replicate the playability of Natural Gut very well, but also brings the cost down as well, so that's a good little tip right there. That's a quick look at hybrids and why you'd want to try a hybrid string in your racquet. Of course, if you have any questions, be sure to give us a call here at Tennis Warehouse or check out a lot of the information we have on our Improve page in our Learning Center. You'll find everything you need to know to get the perfect string grip for your racquet. Thanks for watching.